Hello, procrastinators! This week, Nvidia unveiled three new graphics cards shitting on the PlayStation 5, the Xbox Series X, and Gibbons like Matt, who brought a 2080 Ti. First in the new range was the 3070, a GPU coming in at £470 and reaching the dizzying heights of 20 made-up GPU points, or teraflops as they're known. That takes the Series X's 12 teraflops and the PS5's 13 teraflops and just shits on them. Like, just a lot of shit. Just tons of it. Everywhere. Splattered. AMD aren't even playing, and they've got some on them. And beyond that was the middle child, the 3080, at £650. Well, let's be honest, if you have LEDs in your PC, this is the one you're gonna go for. It's got twice the kick of the old 2080 at £100 less than that launched for. It's quite the beast. But the 3090, a £1,400 monster the size of two 1980s mobile phone top glued together, packs a 35 teraflop punch, almost triple the power of the next-gen consoles, and is out before them. Nvidia call it the first 8K GPU, which is dumb and I honestly love it, but let's be honest, you don't need it. With 24GB of RAM, this one's for the ultra dorks, you know, the 3D renderers, the ones who want to stream ray-traced games, or play a lot of VR. Or, hang on a second.
Hello?
Hey Matt, can we afford
it? Immediately no.
You don't even know what I'm about to ask.
You want the RTX 3090? You were going to say the 3090, weren't you? You were, weren't you?
Anyway, did I mention that I have a Patreon and live streams and a box here with quarters in it? Also this week, Nintendo did a Mario Direct, revealing a collection of old 3D Mario games that for some fucking reason isn't going to stick around. Super Mario 3D All-Stars is an exciting prospect. Nice, rezzed-up versions of Mario 64, Mario Sunshine, and Mario Galaxy. Not Mario Galaxy 2, apparently fuck that game. But Nintendo will stop selling it in March next year. Yeah, in less than 6 months, the game just goes pfft, and you can't buy it physically or digitally ever again. What the fuck? Look, I never took business studies. I was too busy fingering people behind the bike sheds. I was playing Yu-Gi-Oh, shut up. But I know that low supply and high demand increases price. And now, digital games are technically infinite supply. So is this a move from Nintendo to try and keep the price high on their games? Well, no, because Nintendo games never ever fucking lower in price. Breath of the Wild launched at £60 3.5 years ago, and today, I've checked, it's still fucking £60. Look, Nintendo, if you sell this Mario game for £50 today, or £50 later, you're still getting £50. Right, and today is the least number of Switch owners in that potential timeline, with every day onwards being more potential customers. So cutting off the supply, which is infinite, as you get more customers, I don't understand. It's not like Nintendo have enough fucking Switches for everyone anyway. Look, to me, this just puts all the power in the hands of scalpers and pirates, which Nintendo always seem to fucking do. Amiibos, NES Classic, those goddamn Animal Crossing cards. That last one, oh, if you don't know, Nintendo sold Animal Crossing cards that acted like Amiibos, so you could bring any villager you collected into your town. Nice idea. Although they're impossible to get a hold of, and it cost £5 for three random cards, with one always being one of the main characters, like Nook or Isabel. So it's like making two random cards for a fucking cards of popular characters started to creep up in price until certain ones hit triple figures, a price that Nintendo don't get a cent out of. And then, recently, people worked out you can just load loads of card information on a cheap NFC card, and now you can buy hundreds of the fucking things for a few quid. Again, with Nintendo not seeing a cent because there's technically pirated copies. Look, Nintendo, stop with this nonsense. It's silly. Just artificial scarcity in the most artificial fucking way possible. Silly. Bad. Bad silly. Not good silly. You did good silly this week as well. Those fucking Mario Kart AI toys are also revealed this week. That's the shit you're good at. They look fucking incredible. As long as they're not too expensive. Hang on, let me just have a quick Google. £100?! Each? Hang on a second.
Hello?
Hey Matt, can we afford-
Nope.
You did-
Mario Karts.
Fuck you. Anyway, let's talk good news of the week. This week we've had some belters get released. Crusader Kings 3 received a 10 out of 10 for IGN. Seriously, a 10 out of 10 from IGN. I've said that so many times as a joke, but they genuinely gave it a 10 out of 10 for fucking Crusader Kings, and I'm seeing nothing but praise for it. I will have to dip into that at some point. I'll need a lot of time, but I'm definitely going to dip into it. Also, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2 released two well-deserved fucking praise as well. I put 10 hours into the demo of that game. The single level demo, and I can confirm that it's as good a feeling as Tony Hawk's ever was. Possibly even better. That is genuinely, for me, a Game of the Year contestant. I mean, it's not going to win because Factorio came out. But, you know, it's fucking close. And also, be sure to check out Spiritfarer and A Short Trip, both of which came out recently. Spiritfarer is a gentle exploration slash survival slash euthanasia game with incredible art and animation. And A Short Trip is a little game about a bird called Claire going on a short hike that I absolutely adored my few hours with. Also, you can put a hat on the bird. Always love that. But anyway, that's it for this week. On Sunday, the long live stream will start at 3 p.m. UK time, a little later than normal, as I'm staying up to watch AEW. And it'll feature me, it'll feature Matt, and it will feature Multiplayer Flight Sim. Yeah. And then Twitch is now letting me stream videos from Amazon Prime Video thing, so I'm actually starting of thinking I might be doing a regular TV watching stream throughout the week. I don't know when yet, but I keep an eye out for that, because there's a show on Amazon Prime that I very much like to watch with everybody. It's one of the greatest shows of all time. That's right, I will be doing commentary and chatting to you fine folks over MasterChef Australia. That's the future of content, baby. That right there. Anyway, that's all from me. I've got a GPU to buy.
No, you fucking don't.
Hello, everyone. Earlier in this video, I referred to the game A Short Hike as A Short Trip. Dull. So this is a bit of the end where I'm drying my hair at the moment. Maybe I should have stopped the hairdryer. But yeah, I meant to say A Short Hike. What a klutz.